Adenium obesum, we also call it as a desert rose. It's a wonderful tuberous plant which gives you lots of flowers most of the year. And it's not a very difficult plant to grow. Today I'm showing how to repot a grown-up Adenium obesum bonsai. Now see, I'm just cutting out all the old rotten roots. This is very important for Adenium whenever you want to repot, because fungus can attack all these tuberous roots very, very easily. So clean up. Maybe you have to wash it thoroughly. I've already done it. And then clean it up, cut all the dead roots, even the longer roots. Our roots are very thin, our roots are which are crisscrossing each other. So this is the way you just clean up the whole root structure. And I am spraying with hydrogen peroxide, 3% diluted. That keeps the fungus away. And also I have chopped some top branches. And all those places I am applying fungicide. It could be a SAF or any other fungicide, matter of fact. This will seal off. See, you can see all the roots I have put fungicide. And also on the top of the plant, you can dilute the fungicide with water and keep on applying all the cut surfaces wherever you have pruned it. So I have pruned almost all the branches of the plant, just kept few. The ideal time is in the monsoon time or even just before summer, but not definitely in winter. Literally, you apply all the cut edges of the roots and even the branches. Anywhere, any injury to plant, you must apply fungicide, because Adenium obesum is very, very susceptible to fungal diseases, and fungus can make the root rot or even the trunk rot. Plants may die. It's very difficult to save them. Choose a suitable pot. Some people prefer deeper pots, but this particular Adenium is almost 20-year-old, very, very matured and very old plant. So I would like to pot it in a bonsai pot. Aim is to restrict its growth, allow the root hair to grow more. The general rules to fix up such a heavy plant on a flat pot, you need to nicely wrap down the whole system on the bottom of the pot. Most of the bonsai growers know how to stabilize the plant in a pot. You take an aluminum wire or a copper wire, just pass through the holes, put a wire mesh on the top, and the wire ends will be handy to stabilize the plant in the pot. You have just seen now, I have just anchored 4 wire ends. I have kept it ready for plant to be fixed in the pot. This pot has also been cleaned thoroughly. If you are repotting in the same older pot, there is a risk of fungus, so you clean it thoroughly with the soap water, and you may spray it with hydrogen peroxide before potting. This is very, very important. It can really save your plant. Positioning the plant is also very important. See, bonsai is just not growing a aged plant in a flat pot. There are some aesthetics, beauty, composition, design. This has roots grown one side, probably because of growing in a different pot in a wrong angle. So I would like to put a stone there so that to stabilize. It cannot be straight upright position, especially the tuberous plants are difficult to train in a traditional bonsai designs. This can be an unorthodox design. You can see those two long branches. I will also cut them later after I get good foliage. So I have chosen a small stone and try to stabilize it. Mostly I have made a ready mix for these plants. I don't add any red soil or a black soil. I use 60% sand and a bit of compost, little bit of neem cake to prevent root rot, and lot of stones and crocks on the bottom of the plant. So this is already a ready mix. Then maybe on the top layers I would like to add some compost. And I do not really recommend to use coco peat for adenium plants. They may likely to rot. So this is a, first I poured a lot of sand, and the next one was, this is a little bit of neem cake to prevent pests in the root. Little bit of bone meal is also ideal to add. Do not add any fertilizers like DAP or NPK in the repotting period, because adenium doesn't need a lot of fertilizer during repotting. This is a bone meal I have added. Now you try again to fix the plant so that little bit of leftovers fungicide also I have added in the soil, because there is a extreme degree of risk for all adeniums to get affected by fungal disease. Literally, once a fungal disease attacks, the root rot, and very, very difficult to save adenium plants. So my dear friends, use thoroughly whatever fungicide left over. I am just mixing in the soil also. It's a good idea to add some fungicide in the soil too. Now let us refix the plant, spread the roots across. Already I have cut lots of roots, and the branches also I have cut. This has a good trunk, very nice caudex, and probably the next year it will get very good foliage. Next season I will get a lot of flowers out of it. After repotting, do not keep it under sun directly. Keep it in a shade for 1 week to 10 days and gradually bring it to the light. I have to use the stone definitely to fill up the gap in the root. Yeah, so that the plant remains more or less vertical. I have some adenium plants which also have a very slanting style, but ideally most of the adenium plants cannot grow like a banyan or peepal or other common bonsai trees which we use. This is a mixture of a sand and vermicompost, and there is no coco peat and soil in my soil mix. And nicely push your soil mix deeply between the roots. There should be no air gaps. Should nicely fill up all the gaps. Always keep watching from all directions. It is nicely placed slightly away from center line. Probably the pot shape suits it. I don't like to pot adeniums on a square pots, because Adenium, the trunk is always very, very roundish. The whole plant structure is very, very round in nature. It is better to pot always rectangular or squarish, but the pot should be the roundish. It's better. Do not pot in a very angular, squarey pots. So I have fixed the plant with the wires from the bottom of the plant, from the bottom of the pot. Now the plant is very stable. This is very important to stabilize the heavy plants on a pot, because of the drift of air or while you water, they may move away from the pot, and then that can cause danger to roots. So every plant, bonsai especially, when you pot, it should be very, very tightly stable in the pot. Now slowly I'm packing up the soil which I have already readily kept. Tightly pack it. You can see my pot is old pot. Yeah, I didn't have a ready-made pot to pot it. I have chopped almost all branches, because this will help the roots to grow. Now I want more growth at the roots, so that the plant gets stabilized in the pot, and eventually, probably in early spring, it will grow its top, all branches, lots of leaves, and definitely it's going to bloom in next 2-3 months heavily. Desert plants can grow even anytime, even in winter also. Sometimes you can, ideally we don't plant in winter, but sometimes Adeniums can really settle well even in the winters, because they are basically winter loving, sun loving plants. They can easily grow a lot of shoots and flowers. I will probably try and see the later pictures of this plant and post you how it looks. If you see this plant, it has got a human body shape. The lower body and the upper body branches look like two hands. This is all in your imagination. You can design your plant in a very different manner. Yeah, this looks quite nice, well set in the pot, and the size of the trunk, you know, the diameter of the trunk, caudex, should be less than 1/3, 1/4 of the pot. You can see this can be a front view. Actually, this plant can be viewed from any direction. I would probably, yeah, I am sitting just front of the plant. That's probably the front face of the bonsai. You can see one long branch on the top. You don't worry, I will eventually cut it off. I just left it because it has a lot of buds. Yeah, now plant is quite stable. This looks very nice. Can you imagine, this is a more than 20 year old. I have grown it when it was only few months old plant. I bought it for 35 rupees from a local nursery. Now it should definitely cost more than 10,000 rupees. You cannot fix a price for this aged matured plants. Sky is the limit.